what are those numbers on your lenses? For example, on the Canon 15-45mm kit lens, you would see the numbers 3.5-6.3. Now, to understand what that is, we need to talk about aperture. Aperture is simply how much light passes through the lens onto the camera sensor. And the numbers relate to the opening of the lens. So for example, if you have a lens that's at f2, the opening of the lens would be quite large. This would also enable more light to pass through the lens, and it also gives you a narrow depth of field, otherwise known as, you know, background blur. And then the higher the number, the smaller that opening is to let in less light. And also the depth of field is much wider. So try to wrap your head around that. I know for some of you, it's the first time you're hearing this, but it'll be more clear when you see the examples I'm about to show you. Now, what we talked about in terms of aperture, keep that in mind as we talk about the 15-45mm kit lens. On the front of the lens, you're also going to see some numbers that say 3.5-6.3. This is the aperture range that the kit lens has. Now, what this means is that at 15mm, the kit lens's aperture range, maximum aperture range, is 3.5. However, when you zoom out to 45mm, now your maximum aperture range is 6.3. So you'll see in this demonstration, as I zoom out to 45mm, you see how the aperture changed from 3.5-6.3, and now you see how dark it is because we've lost some light. Now, I can't change the aperture because this is the max aperture that's available at 45mm. Now, if I zoom back out, you'll see I now return to 3.5. So now that you know this about the lens, one of the biggest things I encourage people to do is when they're using the kit lens, let's say for a talking head video like this, I encourage you not to zoom your lens out further than 20mm. Because at 20mm, you could still get f4. Anything higher, you are now pushing the aperture higher. Now, for whatever reason, you have to zoom out at 6.3. Let's say you're taking portraits, or you want that really zoomed in look and you want to blur the background. Just know that at 6.3, you're going to have more light available. So if you're outdoors, this should be fine. But if you're indoors, you would need fairly powerful lights, at least two lights, to keep that ISO down. Now, if you have to raise the ISO, I recommend trying not to go further than 1600, 2000 at the most. The combination of the kit lens and the M50, it's not the best in low light in this combination, but it's always best to have more light than not enough light. And to get that blurry background at 6.3, keep in mind that your subject has to be as far away from the background as possible. You know, people that say the kit lens isn't capable of background blur, that's hogwash. It's more about location and placement to get that blurry background at any f-stop, really. Now, I really wanted to make this video to explain this because in the next video, we're going to talk about moving from automatic to manual settings on your Canon M50. Now, to do that, you need to understand aperture and the aperture ranges on your zoom lenses, like the kit lens or any other zoom lens that has an aperture range. So be sure to check out that end card coming up, or I'll leave it in the description below. If it's not there, that means I'm just editing it, but It's a video to watch because those of you that are still working in auto, it's time to get you off auto and onto manual settings. It'll give you more control and you'll be able to manipulate your camera and the lighting to the look that you want. And you know the formalities, subscribe, notification bell, like, it helps the channel out and it pushes my content to more people. I'd appreciate if you can do that for me. So yeah, we'll talk to you soon.